welcome everybody out to Open Media Sessions. Give yourselves a round of applause for coming out. Welcome. Yes. So happy to be here with you. My name is Daniel Reskin, a local comedian and proud member of Denver Open Media. I'll be here to guide you on this journey of music, comedy, community spotlights, and more. Pure entertainment tonight. So, thank you for joining us. I'd like to say hi to all our listeners and viewers out there in TV land, because we are, as a public access station, broadcasting live on 881 right now for HD and 57 on Comcast. So check us out. How we doing? How we doing, HD? How my pores? We good? We good, HD? It's a little too close. Okay, zoom out. I'm sorry. Also to our radio listeners, I want to say hi to 104.7 KOMF. To all you listening out there, keep your eyes on the road and enjoy. Great to be here, everybody. So a little about Open Music Sessions. This is our big block party we do every first Friday of the month, and it's a showcase. It's where Denver Open Media is our most open. This is where you can come check out everything. Check out these beautiful studios and all these fancy cameras. Check out our editing bays, our equipment, our tools, and enter a raffle to become a member. Enter the raffle. Have you entered? Have you entered? Have you entered? I hope so. I hope so. That's how I became a member here. I actually won the raffle. You win a free class and I believe a year of basic membership. And it was enough to get me started. And I made my own TV show, which you have not seen. But I might change that one day. So definitely thank you for being here. And besides Denver Open Media, we have a fantastic lineup for you tonight. We have got a band. They have just released an album, so you know they're fresh, they're tight, they're ready to kill it for you all tonight. Everybody give it up for Jux County. Jux County is going to be here. Very, very excited to have them. I hear they're Denver standards, so I'm only 2 years in. I'm not a native, so I need to get cultured tonight. I'm going to get schooled. We also have an amazing stand-up comedian tonight. I have had the pleasure of knowing this fella as a fellow stand-up comedian. This guy is the Denver crusher. He is the hometown hero. He's all over. He's at Comedy Works, and he also is the king of Boulder comedy, if you ever go up into Boulder. I don't know why you would. But everybody give it up for Brent Gill, who will be joining us tonight. Oh. He will rock you. And so from here, before we get into all that fantastic entertainment, we are here for Denver. It's all about the community. We like to spotlight various organizations here. And we have a member of the DOM staff here to take us on that journey and to meet Revision, a fantastic community group. So I'd love to welcome Alex on stage. Yeah. Everybody. And this is for your guests. Take it from here. Thank you.
So every month at Open Media Foundation, we have something called the Community Spotlight, where we focus on a nonprofit in the Denver community that needs a little bit more of attention, a little bit more of a love. And this month is Revision, who focuses mainly on the Denver community. And to talk a little bit more about it is their program manager, Kristen.
Thanks, Alex. Thanks, everybody. I'm super excited to be here and really grateful for the opportunity to tell you guys a little bit about Revision and what we do. So we're a community-based organization working primarily in the area of Southwest Denver. And we're working to really transform. We work directly with residents to transform what used to be a food desert into an awesome, healthy, thriving community. The primary way we do that is through a backyard garden program. So we have an awesome team of 10 promotoras that are matched up with residents throughout the community. And they really just follow those families through every step of the way in creating, building a vegetable garden in their backyard, and then checking up on that garden throughout the season, and really just learning how to grow their own food. So I have the honor of working with that amazing team of 10 promotoras, and one of them is with us tonight, Yuri Baena. So I'm going to pass the microphone to her so she can tell you a little bit more about our programs.
All Mucho gusto. Entonces, ¿puedes decir algo sobre su posición como promotora?
Hola, buenas noches. Mucho gusto, Alex. Yo empecé teniendo mi propio jardín en mi casa y después me contrataron como promotora. Tengo 5 años trabajando en revisión. El año pasado también me dieron la oportunidad de trabajar y empezar como coordinadora de la cocina, porque también tenemos clases de nutrición y clases de recetas saludables para las familias. Yo empecé así, siendo de la misma comunidad, empecé como promotora en este programa.
¿Y la historia de revisión?
Revisión empezó en el 2009 con nuestro director Eric Kornakit, con 7 jardines. Al año, en el 2010, tuvimos el programa de promotores que empezaron con 3, con 36 jardines. Hasta el año pasado tuvimos 450 familias involucradas en este programa y tenemos 10 promotores.
¿Y cómo son sus clientes?
A nosotros no les llamamos clientes, son participantes de la misma comunidad. Trabajamos en el suroeste de Denver, específicamente en la comunidad de Westwood, y son las mismas familias que se les pregunta si quieren estar en este programa, y ellos son nuestros participantes.
¿Y qué tal su experiencia en revisión como promotora?
La experiencia para mí es fantástica. A mí me emociona mucho porque yo salí de la misma comunidad y a mí me gusta trabajar con la gente. Entonces, Revision nos da la oportunidad de trabajar en nuestra comunidad y de dar un poquito de todo lo que nos han dado nuestros mismos participantes. No solo nosotros les enseñamos, también ellos nos enseñan.
Y antes de terminamos, ¿puedes decir algo sobre sus eventos en Denver?
Nosotros también tenemos un mercado que abrimos los martes y los viernes de 12 a 6, el sábado de 10 a 3. Este es un mercado para la comunidad. La mejor forma de apoyarnos sería que nos visitaran. Estamos en la comunidad de Westwood, en Morrison Road. Y este también es un mercado piloto porque la comunidad está pidiendo una cooperativa. La cooperativa no solamente son los miembros, sino también son dueños de este mercado, y ese dinero no se va a ir a otro lado, se va a quedar en nuestra comunidad para seguir apoyándonos.
So I think you guys have a video that you want to show us, and Kristen's going to tell us a little bit more about what the video will entail.
Yeah, thank you, Alex, and thank you, Yuri. That was such a great overview of all the different programs that we have. It's really been exciting in Revision to see the growth. We started, as Yuri was explaining, with 7 gardens in 2009, and last year we had a little over 400. So we're really kind of taking over the Southwest Denver area and making an awesome food oasis out of it. So I think you'll see a lot of that in the video that we're about to see, and thank you again for this awesome opportunity. I look forward to the music and the comedy.
Thank you, guys.
Revision is an organization with people who care about transforming low-income communities to sustainable communities.
Westwood is a working-class neighborhood in southwest Denver. For decades, Westwood was neglected and in decline. Businesses left, including the last grocery store. Infrastructure crumbled. Jobs were hard to come by. Schools were overcrowded and underperformed. The streets became unsafe. Parents were afraid to let their children play outside. Residents here face disproportionate health and economic disparities. For starters, it is a food desert where residents can't access or afford healthy food.
El problema del desierto de comida sana no es solo en Westwood. En Estados Unidos hay alrededor de 23 millones y medio de personas viviendo así. Por lo tanto, el derecho a acceso a comida sana no debería de ser un privilegio, debe de ser un derecho. Más de 13 millones y medio de dólares se van de nuestra comunidad al año debido a la necesidad que tenemos de comprar nuestros alimentos en los supermercados alrededor de nuestra comunidad. Por esta y muchas razones más, nuestra expectativa de vida se reduce 12 años.
Oh, in my case, I have to ride like 10 minutes. And I have a lot of people who they didn't have car, then they have to wait a bus for half hour and then half hour to go, half hour to come.
Pues para mí vivir en un desierto de alimentos es difícil, es un poco difícil porque no tenemos nada cerca.
En un desierto de comida hay muchos problemas de salud como diabetes, alta presión, obesidad.
Westwood is a beautiful place, and despite these challenges, people are overcoming all odds to build a healthy, thriving community. In 2009, Revision started partnering with the Westwood community to find solutions in people's backyards. Revision believes that the people living in a community should be at the forefront of solving their problems. The people of a community are the greatest resource. We began hiring residents from the neighborhood to teach their neighbors how to grow their own food. Our vision was to create a food system by the community, of the community, and for the community. Promotores are becoming experts on gardening, healthy eating, cooking, and nutrition.
Gracias a Revisión, yo he aprendido a tener mi jardín, a cómo mantenerlo.
Well, I learned about nutrition, I learned about how to grow the garden, I learned how to speak with the people.
Since 2009, Revision has helped over 600 families learn to grow their own food, making it the largest community-led food access program in the country.
Revision boils down to being a part of a community, no matter what your differences are. When you see a sign in someone's yard, you know that they're part of Revision. That connects you.
When Promotores identified that people didn't know how to eat with some of the foods from their garden or how to cook healthy meals, they worked with a nutritionist to develop their own cooking curriculum, which they now teach.
De tener, cuando ya empecé a tener mi jardín y tenía mis propios vegetales, pero había muchas que no sabía cómo prepararlos, entonces desperdiciaba bastante comida o a veces la regalaba. Revisión construyó la cocina para apoyar a la comunidad, dándoles clases de nutrición y dándoles clases de cómo mejorar sus recetas. La cocina me ha traído muchos beneficios al poder aprender a cocinar más saludable y también al poder compartir todos estos beneficios con mi familia y con mis participantes. También me ayuda a crecer más amistades.
Grocery stores won't open in Westwood because they feel there isn't enough money to be made from a lower income community.
When Promotores realized that a grocery store was not going to open anytime soon in Westwood, they organized their neighbors and decided to start their own.
Lo más importante de esto, de nuestra cooperativa de Westwood, los residentes son los socios, los principiantes de este mercado, supermercado.
Westwood needs a grocery store that supports its neighbors, that looks for ways to give back. And with a grocery store that's owned by the people of Westwood, I think you'll see something that you haven't seen in this country.
Something that we can grow for ourselves, that money can stay with ourselves, good food can be stay with ourselves too.
This is the Revision model, to invest in people so they can change their neighborhood. This is about creating ownership. It is about creating a local economy that is owned by the people and uplifts an entire community together. The Revision model is working and is inspiring other communities to rethink how to solve their challenges. We've accomplished a lot, but we aren't quite there yet. Our work needs another 5 years to truly take root and transform Westwood into a model of community development that will become a shining example for the rest of the country to follow. But we are facing a new challenge, one that is moving with surprising speed and appetite. Westwood is experiencing gentrification and development pressures that threaten to undermine all we've accomplished. It's no secret that Denver is changing, and changing rapidly. Last year, Denver was the sixth fastest growing city in the country. As a housing shortage drives up housing prices, historically low-income neighborhoods such as Westwood are suddenly seeing an increase in popularity. People that can't afford trendier neighborhoods are now moving here, and it is driving up the cost of housing to the point where the people who have lived in Westwood for decades can no longer afford the increase in rent and property taxes. They are becoming displaced and forced to move to neighborhoods further and further away. What type of city are we building, and who are we building it for?
Yo aquí con mi familia tenemos viviendo 15 años aquí en esta casa, en este barrio. Están solas, están remodelando para lo mismo venderse o subir las rentas muy caras. Aquí una renta donde vivimos de una casa, dos, tres recámaras, son de 1,800, 1,000, hasta $2,000. Se me haría mucho muy difícil porque, por todo muy, muy difícil. En primer lugar, que no conoce uno gente, y aquí pues me conozco toda la gente, el barrio me gusta, ya cambió muchas cosas. Y si me muevo a otro lugar, pierdo la mayoría de todo. Trabajo en primer lugar, las oportunidades que me dan aquí con el barrio, de muchas cosas.
Does development have to lead to displacing people with less economic security? We don't think so. Development in itself isn't a bad thing, but when development displaces people because they don't have the power to influence it, then we have to question the model. Revision's model of development is different. Low-income communities should have the right to guide and influence development in their own backyards. It's about development from the ground up, from the inside out. It's about helping the people build an economy they own. It's about building strength and resilience through the power of community. This is economics as if people mattered. And it's working. We're just getting started. Our vision is to build community wealth by inspiring new models, such as community land trusts, cooperative housing, worker-owned businesses, and community-owned finance institutions. It's about democratic participation that leads to community ownership and equitable resources and benefits. This is a new model of development. Believe in the power of these people, because we are all Westwood. We can't do it alone. We need your help. Crecimos Unidos. Grow with us.
And welcome back, everybody. Let's give it up for Revision. Mm-hmm. Fantastic. I hope you all are informed. Get involved with that. It was muy informativo y muy divertido. Anyone? Huh? Aprendiendo? Anyone working on their Rosetta Stone? All right. Well, it's good. We've got to keep it diverse here. It's a beautiful 2016 world. All right. So, lovely audience, it's time for personally my favorite part of the show. I love the music. I love the music. But it's comedy time, everybody. Are you ready for comedy? Yeah. I'm going to take that as a no. And we'll just stop now, okay? No, you've been a lovely audience so far in this beautiful, highly technological studio. You've been quiet and beautiful and present. But now that makes you a bad audience, okay? Because we don't need quiet. Comedians need energy to live, or else we don't survive. So we got to bring that energy. Can we try a ha, like one of those for no reason ha's? Ha!
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 Ha! Ha! Okay, all right. That was B+, guys. Not bad, for just off the cuff. All right, that's fantastic, good. We need that energy, we love that. This next comedian, such a pleasure to introduce him. He's hot off a tour, he's just been touring the country for a few months, the Gill Meets World Tour. He's always at Comedy Works, he'll be headlining next month, and you can check his monthly show, Infomation, as well. Everybody, it is my pleasure to introduce Mr. Brent Gill.
Yeah! Reskin! We're doing it! What's up? What's up, camera? Cut to this one, quickly. Cut to that. Yeah! No, this one. Cut to that one. Yeah! What's up, world? Hello. We're getting international with it, aren't we? Look at my nose hairs. I need to trim them. I've been on tour for a freaking month. Look at that. All right. I wasn't planning on that either. Hello, everybody. Thank you. See, he was rehearsing his ha. See that? Ha ha! Whoa, you sound maniacal with that one. Hello, everyone. I want to move all of this here, which is going to really mess up the band. And I'm going to switch. No. All right. Hey, guys. Look, here's the deal. This show is FCC regulated, so I'm not allowed to swear at all. So I'm going to try and sneak one in just real quick before they, like, cut me off or anything. I apologize if we get fined for this. It's the most vile word that you can think of. I'm sorry. Trump! All right. There we go. Sorry. All right, my parents would be so angry with me. Hi, everybody. My name is Brent Gill. I eat at Chili's alone. It's good to be here. Heck yeah, look at these B cups. Come on, I know what I'm doing. That's those Southwestern egg rolls right there that have been crushing me right there. I chose my HP Inkjet number 951 magenta shirt today to really accent my B cups here, you know. This is a true statement. I one time Googled the nutritional value of Chili's Southwestern egg rolls. You know what came up on the interwebs? You're excited for this, aren't you? You ready? No, get excited. I'm telling you, here's what came up. It didn't even give me a calorie count. It just said it takes 278 minutes of walking to walk off one order of Southwestern egg rolls. I was like, well, bring out a bigger bra and a side of Lipitor because that is not gonna happen. And, like, I love how the internet knows if you're Googling the nutritional value of Chili's Southwestern egg rolls, your fat ass isn't running anywhere, you know? Was that okay? You guys clammed up on that. Am I allowed to say that one? I already did, so it's too late now. So, sorry if that wasn't okay. Moving on with the jokes. Okay. Ah, man, I feel like they should have used other units of measurement, you know? Like something more realistic that fat people can get behind, right? Like, I want to Google the nutritional value of Chili's Southwestern egg rolls and see. It takes 418 frames of bowling to bowl off one order of Southwestern egg rolls. Or, like, it takes 320 hours of Segway riding to ride off 1 hour or 1 hour of egg rolls. That's a lot of egg rolls. I am on an international tour right now. I literally flew into Denver like 4 hours ago, and I came here pretty much straight through because I wanted to eat all the food upstairs, which thank you to those sponsors for that. And the international tour, this is day 45 of it, and by international, I mean I spent 3 days in Toronto, and the rest have been in the United States of America. Real cultured here. It's weird because I told this joke in Toronto about their homeless people there. And Toronto is super, super nice, right? And I told this joke, which they hated because they like their homeless people. Which is weird because here in Denver, we treat our homeless people like geese, right? Wow, that was really divided. This side was okay with it. And you guys were like, ooh, I don't know about that one, B-cups. Let's figure something. Think about it. Like, homeless people, geese are the same thing. Like, once the homeless people go home, we're like, all right, fall must be right around the corner. Wow, okay. You guys, that's divisive. All right, that's all right. I disagree with you entirely. If you didn't laugh at that, you're wrong. I'm just gonna say it. You're flat out wrong. Because they're the same species. Like, let's compare them side by side, shall we? You're darn right we shall. It's my part of the show. That's what we're gonna do. Bums, geese, same thing, right? Fact number one, they both have no problem overrunning public parks. Boom, fact. Come on, right side of the house, come on. Woo! Number two, they both have no problem diarrhea-ing all over the sidewalk. That's a fact. Number three, homeless people, geese, I hit them both with my car. Boom, fact. Did you just turn me down because I'm wicked loud or did I ruin this microphone already? Sound booth, I'm looking into you right now. Are we good? Thumbs up. You're ruining my time.
Oh, man, it's fun to be back, you guys. I travel a whole bunch. I like traveling a lot because when I travel, I'm the kind of guy, I take the Denver laws to full effect. I like to get as high as I possibly can on the way to the airport. And I don't know if you guys agree with me on that one, but that is how I like to travel, right? Because I live in Capitol Hill, right? So I'm the kind of guy that I'll roll up two joints with the drive to the airport. However, it's a 20-minute drive to said airport. So therefore, I find myself halfway through, 10 minutes in, just like halfway through the first joint, like, oh God, we gotta hurry up here. We gotta go. And then I just light the other one with the first one, and it's okay. I asked if I was allowed to talk about weed on this show, and they said, yes, absolutely, we encourage it. It's okay. Who do you think has antennas? People that smoke a lot of weed, all right? So now I'm double fisting two joints, just trying to get through it quickly, like go, and like everyone in my Uber pool is pissed, you know? You guys are fun. You guys like the weed jokes? You like the bum jokes? We're gonna find one that brings us all together here. It's gonna be really great. I can't wait. I do live in Capitol Hill, right in the heart of the gayborhood up there, and I don't know if we have any gabers here. Yeah, high five. What up? Dude, I love that neighborhood. I've been there for 7 years, back when rent was cheap, you know? Like, it was so great. And I've been there for so long that I feel like I fit into my neighborhood way better than any straight dude should ever fit into a neighborhood whose King Supers is called the Queen Supers. Right? Like, I think the reason why I fit in so well, to be honest, is I think it's five things. I think it's the fact I'm 31, I am single, I live alone with a cat. Someone just goes, yep, there it is. Don't forget, there's a fifth one, I also drive a Subaru, all right? So like, yeah, I am like the second or third hairiest lesbian in my neighborhood, y'all. It's crazy. And I love my cat, like a lot, you know, like a lot, right? And I, not in a weird way, a lot. I saved his life, so I have a connection with him, you know? Like, I went to the Dumb Friends League. They had Sarah McLachlan playing live in the background, you know? And I'm walking the aisles, I'm looking at the merchandise, and I come to the little holding tank for cats, right? I don't actually know if that's what it was officially called. Maybe there wasn't a sign above it. It might have been called like a kitten corral. I have no idea. But so I see my cat. I have a tuxedo cat, right? He looks like Sylvester from Sylvester and Tweety. And I was like, ooh, I want to see that one. So I say to the wrangler, I was like, yo, you got to be paying attention sometimes. Come on. I know I look like this, but I'm on point. Yes. My Capitol Hill neighbors really enjoyed that. Thank you. I appreciate that. So I say to the wrangler, I was like, yo, I want to see that cat, lasso him up. So he goes in there, and he doesn't, like, throw a rope and grab him and flip him over. He just, like, kind of goes down there and picks him up and brings him out to me, which is very uneventful. But I was playing with the cat, and I was like, yes, this thing's the one. I'll take him, wrap him up. How much do you want? And he looks me dead in the eye, and he doesn't blink, and he goes, well, it's $149 adoption fee plus the price of shots. Sorry, $149 for a used animal? Are you serious? I brought like $63. Do you have anything on clearance or something? Like, what about that three-legged cat with no hair? I'll take that thing. $46. What do you want? Just lonely, please. And now. I really want to share this with you guys a lot because I feel like a lot of you live here and a lot of the people watching the show live in this area, so you can probably appreciate this. The people that live in apartments and condos who have neighbors that don't like when you get really loud. And so 5.5 years ago, so I've been there for 7 years. 5.5 years ago, I got my neighbor, the crackhead, kicked out, which was super fun. And then a pair of hipsters moved in after her. Now, I say a pair of hipsters because that's what I call, like, a group of hipsters. Like, there's, like, a gaggle of geese. There's a flock of seagulls. It's a pair of hipsters because you can't ever tell them apart. Like, I don't know which one's the dude, which one's the chick. They wear the same pants. I have no idea. So they came in 5.5 years ago, and they left a note on my door one day. And I came home from work, and I see this note, and I was like, and I almost tore it up and just called it that. And then I read it, and I was like, well, this is hilarious. So what I did was I decided I'm going to go downstairs and I'm going to address this note to my neighbors point by point, face to face. Because there's one thing I know for a fact, Denver Open Media. That is, if you're the kind of person that leaves a note on someone's door, you hate confrontation, right? I'm a comedian. I talk to strangers all day long. I'm like, bring it on, pair of hipsters. Let's do this, right? So here's how it works, right? This is exactly how they wrote the note. First off, they go, dear neighbors. I was like, wait a minute, I live alone. They go, don't know how to say this without sounding like jerks. That part was added right there. But we can hear everything. Like when you guys get into your screaming rage matches. Okay, I live alone. That's what I said. I'm like, I live alone. They go, well, we can hear two voices yelling at each other. I'm like, yeah, that's me. They're like, no, we hear two different voices. I'm like, yeah, I yell at myself and then I respond in a different voice. I'm not crazy, okay? Screaming rage matches, or when you have sex with your girlfriend late at night and super early in the morning. I was like, look, I can't change the way I masturbate, all right? I can't. We can't ask you to stop having sex, but there has to be some sort of compromise. Maybe you can spend more nights at her place or something. To which I responded with, well, I guess we could move it into the living room or the kitchen. And they both looked at me like, yeah, that's fine. That's fair. I'm like, ooh, gross. Hipsters. Ooh, that's not sanitary. You don't want to cross-contaminate that. Also, what is this creepy instrumental song you have on loop every night? It's a little too loud. Can you at least turn it down? All right, let me explain that last one real quick. That last one there, 5.5 years ago, Planet Earth came out on Blu-ray. Also, 5.5 years ago, dabs got heavily introduced into my life. Now, if you don't know what a dab is, basically what a dab is where Colorado really showed off how intelligent we are of potheads, and we took weed and we turned it into crack, okay? Like that's, yeah, you're getting real quiet right now. Don't worry, I didn't want to do this joke earlier, but this is where we're at right now. So that's what happened. It's super concentrated. You do a little dab, or I'm sure a few of us, dollop, Capitol Hill, come on. And then you basically freebase it, and you're like, ah, right? Like that's what happens. So that all this was happening, and what would happen was at that time I worked at Best Buy. I don't spend my money well, so I invested all my money in a nice surround sound system. So I would go home, put on the Blu-ray Planet Earth on like Jungles or something, and then I would take a dollop, and then I would fall asleep, and then I'd have like this weird soundtrack going on in my head as I'm approaching REM sleep, which like is not good when you're freshly baked, because then it's like a Terrence Malick soundtrack in your head as you're falling asleep. You're like, what's going on? And then what would happen is the Jungles thing would end and it would go to the main menu. And it would play a really creepy instrumental song. And I was like, yeah, that one's my bad. I can fix that one. Sorry. We'll fix that one. They haven't talked to me since. It's been pretty fantastic. So, a few months ago, like right at the beginning of the summer, I had a very American moment where I decided I was going to impulse purchase a gun. Yeah, is that not the most American moment that you can get right there? Is impulse purchasing a handgun? Yes, that is it right there, right? And here's the thing: is I agree with a lot of you in that how ridiculous that sentence is, because I don't think that the words impulse purchase or handgun belong in the same sentence ever. You know, that's one of those things you shouldn't cram those together. You need some thought between those words, right? But here is the sitch. And you guys can cool out. It's nothing bad. I just bought a gun. Don't worry about it. You can loosen your buttholes. It's all right. Because here was the sitch. My friend calls me up and he's like, yo, dude, the wife and I just had a kid. She doesn't want a gun in the house. I'll sell you my .45 caliber M1911, $100. $100? Bro, that's less than a cat. Absolutely. All right, you guys, thank you very much. My name is Brent Gill. Thank you for having me, Denver Open Media. We'll see you next time.
Keep it going for Brent Gill, everybody.
Thank you, everyone. Yes.
You get a taste of what I get to enjoy on the regular. Oh, my God.
There's got to be a better way to say that.
Yeah, probably. Probably. Let's edit that out in post. But tell the people where they can taste you. See you. You got a couple.
I have a booth at the Taste of Colorado. It's a small booth, but okay, sorry.
Right here.
Okay.
That's
all fine. Right. So I work at the Comedy Works. I'll be there. I'm headlining in November. I know this sounds horrible, but the date is between two dates right now. So check out my website, BrentGillComedy.com, for that. You can follow me on Instagram and Twitter at BTGComedy. I also have my calendar and my clips and some pictures of me with famous people like Daniel here.
Yeah. Yeah. That's a draw. Yeah. No one's going to your website now.
It's really got a lot of reach. I mean, 38 people, you guys. Right. It's a pretty big reach for D-Resk here,
that's
over
bright.
Here. That's where you can find me.
BrentGill.com?
Brent Gill Comedy.
Brent Gill
Comedy. Because Brent Gill lives in Oregon. He is 49 years old.
Uh-huh.
He is a notary public.
Oh, I bet he is.
And he has not changed his website for the past 10 years. 10 years, it's been the temporary home of notary public Brent Gill. I'm like, dude, sell me your website, please. And he's like, nah, I think I'm going to do something with it. I'm like, 10 years! 10 years!
You're on blast, Brent Gill, the
Come
real
on, Brent
the,
Gill.
The
no,
notary.
I'm the real Brent Gill. You're the fake Brent Gill, Brent Gill.
That's right. All right. Well, more on this developing story as it continues. Other than that, thanks for being here.
Thank you for
here.
Having me, dude.
Everyone,
I appreciate it.
One more time.
I wore my best purple, you guys.
Brent Gill. Yay. All right. Okay. Everyone in the splash zone, feel free to take down your ponchos now. Everything is okay. Music time. Who wants some music, huh? Yes. That is correct. We've stimulated the talky, thinky part of your brain, and now it's time for the feely, hip gyration-y part of your brain. All the other parts that need to rhythm to move. This band, so excited. They are Denver staples, and they have a fresh album out on Bandcamp. Very excited to hear what they have. Everybody, give an amazing Denver Open Media welcome to Jux County.
All right, thank you. All right. Thank you, Daniel. Thank you, Brent. I'm going to seem really quiet when I talk. Just let me tune my guitar and we'll be on our way. Yeah, so we have a new album out. It's called Coral. You can get it on Bandcamp. Chris has got some t-shirts there if you want to buy a t-shirt.
Free stickers also right here.
And now, wait, I got to hand out the set list. Nothing's worse than people saying, what are we gonna play now? This is called Come See. Sight and mind. Come see me when your past is far behind. Who am I now? Come to the party, to the show. Come have a drink and let your sadness open to the moment. A heart that's closed to everything. Whole existence based on ego. This whole existence is a dream. Stare into the paper sky. I see its meaning through another's eyes. Who am I now? With no idea of where I am. My thoughts are further than the lights of Japan. My heart. I wish one day the door would open, swallow me inside the truth. I know that day will nearly kill me. Better to be killed by the truth than a lie. Safe from the pain of life. Dear, you are my honesty and the fear we have is real. You are the way but not the only way. But you are
I do believe we're a little short on time. Is that correct, or are we? We're good? The song is called Coral. It's the title track to our new album. It's about living in the ocean or in the sky. And I'm supposed to say a line from the, some of these songs. I can't remember why I'm supposed to say it, but I think my favorite line is, the day-to-day will slough it off like we're rattlesnakes. That's my favorite line from this song. All right, thank you. It's a good line, yeah? It's a is short and sweet, but unbearably long. And it's no right or wrong. Just piece by piece by piece until we're gone. In a fantasy, with a finger grip on reality. Sweet insanity. Yes, all coming back to me. Ah, let's live in the sky. And we're looking down and we'll see the clouds go by. Yeah, we'll slough it off like a rattlesnake. Feel the earth as it shakes, shakes, shakes. Oh. And you're here with me. No other place I'd rather be. Anywhere you wanna go is alright with me. It's alright with me. Yeah, yeah. Thank you very much. All right, let's have Denise come up on the stage. You better check this mic, because I don't know if we've ever really checked it too well. Check, check, check.
Check, check.
Can you
check.
Hear yourself there?
Oh, a little bit.
Yeah?
Can you guys start playing?
You want some more?
Yes, please.
Can is that possible?
Check, check, check.
Keep going. Check, 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 check. Kay. Check, check. All right. Good. All right, this song is about touring in England and driving on British roads. It's called M4. Yeah? Tear stains, cold. Talk so fast that I can't write it out. Oh. Forgot the lyrics. Drive your body like a car at 100 miles an hour on a diet of cigarettes and candy bars. Talk so fast that I can't comprehend all your twisted meaning. This truth is just a lie. Can't believe you haven't met your end. Denise Lene, everybody. I could see
this horizon is just a line. Driving the car at such speed, when will it ever be reached? Where is the edge that we see? Somebody tell me the scheme. Do we drive through the heat? Take a turn down some lovely street. I can get out of the car into the lives that we lead. Hop under covers and dream. Wake up and do it.
Thanks. This is called Moving Around. It's kind of about when you get your driver's license and you start cruising around the streets, Colfax being one of them. Feeling so alive, leaving all of your shadows behind, and your favorite songs playing all night long. I was looking at the world in a way I never saw it before, and it's shimmering just outside of my door. Drunks hitting the ground, not that profound. We're just moving around.
Avenue. I muscle cars and feathered hair, but not us, we're in our red VW. Driving up and driving down, we're just moving around.
Thank you.
Yeah.
All right. Anybody remember the Little Russian Cafe? This line, huh? Yeah, Eugene, I used to wash dishes there. All right. This has got a line about the Little Russian Cafe in there. See if you can pick it out. From the land and sea, land would really make me squirm. That's okay, she can get away. I'll never, ever, 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 ever learn. And I said, yeah, I said. Carry on.
I said, I wish you it wouldn't last too long. Told myself that I don't care. Told myself she was never really ever there.
Thanks. Woo! Here we go.
Now we're warming up a little bit. I don't mind saying I'm a little nervous. All these TV cameras on me. Streaming all over the world. Somewhere in Paris, somebody's gonna know I'm out of tune. Qu'est-ce que c'est? I don't know how to say it in French. I'm trying to think of something to say in French, but baguette. Il jouait le guitare très mal. Qu'est-ce qu'il fait? Is that right? No. No, it's not. Ready? All right, this is I'm going to say this one is about tour going to play South by Southwest a long, long time ago. And Mom, cover your ears. We're tripping on acid in a van going down the road. And so it's called Texas Toast, and the line on this is about the traffic signs that you see on the highways of Texas. You know what it is.
One, two, three, four. We're driving down the road, our eyes are wide. Haven't slept for 40 hours, but our eyes are wide. In the field, come on, Chris. Nothing could hex us. We keep on reading signs. Don't mess with Texas. We'll be right back. the city.
Thanks. All right. This next song is called Totem.
Accepting of a million little jerks.
6 minutes and 37 seconds. We might be left. All right, this is our last song, everybody. It's called La La Love. One, two, three, four. Think they can find it stuck in a song. Some people think that they know what it is, but they're wrong. And they're up so high, like a satellite. And you thought that it was, but it was not all along. And the beautiful and the horrible. Up so high that you never wanna come down. You'll be up so high that your shadow won't touch the ground. So that the moon and star and the planet Mars, they all vibrate making such a beautiful sound. Cause it's la 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 love. And it's pumping through your brain like magical blood. And you're in the haze in the days of a beautiful drive. And you're on the edge, on the very edge of a razor blade. And the beauty fades out. That you know what I'm thinking of, and you're falling ever further from above. There are pages and pages, pages of written advertising. You little get it. Woohoo! Yeah. Woo! right. Thanks, everybody. We're Jux County. Everybody out in the world, we're Jux County.
We have free stickers up here.
We got free stickers up here.
T-shirts too.
And thanks, Denver Open Media. And thank everybody for coming and sitting and watching a play.
Yes. All right. Keep it going for Jux County, everybody. Yes. That rocked so hard. And then I'd love to just take a second and if we could let the people, if you have any information where we can find you guys, any we can follow you, stalk you possibly.
Oh, well, like us on Facebook, Jux County on Facebook, and Bandcamp. What is it, Chris? JuxBandcamp.com.
JuxCounty.bandcamp.com.
Yeah, grab a sticker too. They're cool.
You got stickers. We got T-shirts for sale. A free album online on Bandcamp. Follow them, love them.
There's hundreds of them. Take two. Take three.
If I could just make it rain real quick. So guys, thanks for being here. Come get some of these. Make it. It's very rainy in Jux County. That's a sign of respect, by the way. I'm not throwing it on the floor. I'm making it rain. Okay, cool. Just so we're clear. Oh, man. Well, it looks like we did it. All of us, everybody. We have done the impossible, a journey of the soul, of the heart, of the mind. And we had some laughs, had a good time, huh? Had a couple drinks. Yeah. Give it up for Denver Open Media for putting this on. For Revision. For Brent Gill. For Jux County. This amazing resource. I believe we have a raffle to do. Yes. Someone is going to join us. Oh, yes. Well, before the raffle, the sponsors, we must mention Illegal Pete's, Sexy Pizza. Oh, delicious. Sexy and illegal, our food is. I don't know why, but it's delicious, most importantly. The Westward, of course, and Crazy Mountain Brewing Company. I would like to climb that mountain. And Ratio, oh, getting us loose. Ratio Beer Works. Man, we have a lot of great sponsors. Sexpotcomedy.com for all your comedy. If you want to find comedy stuff, Sexpot Comedy, that's where to do it. And Lamar's Donuts. And what else? Circuit City? No, okay, they're bankrupt. I think we'll do the raffle now. One of you is going to become a member. Oh, thank you, Maureen. Let me pick a good one. That one's bad. I hate that one. That one's stinky. Okay. The newest member of the Open Media Foundation here is Taylor Zogelman. Zoggyman? Did I pronounce that right? Is that an I or an L? Zogelman. Oh, ogle. It was the O, like I'm ogling you. I get it. Okay, cool. Well, welcome, Taylor. Thank you. You now are free to take a class. You can learn how all these fancy cameras work. You can make your own TV show. Congratulations. All right. Yes, Taylor. We did it. All right. Well, that is about it. Thanks again to all parties involved. Check us out every first Friday. We do this every month for years. Spotlighting the best in local Denver entertainment and community outreach. My name is Daniel Reskin. Check out my show on Denver Open Media called Casa de Jaja, where I interview comedians. And once again, thank you so much for coming out, everybody. Give yourselves a round of applause and good night. Hit the music. Okay, we're off the air.